teens and ran into the room to help him. She began punching Don in the back, and he spun around and returned the favor by punching her in the face over and over until she stopped moving. He must have thought that they were both dead because he sat down on their couch and smoked a cigarette. What he didn't know was that the couple had a young son in the house, and he had called the police when the fight first began. Don was on his way out the door when the officers arrived, and he was taken into custody. The mother was in critical condition at the hospital, but the husband had unfortunately been pronounced at the scene. Most of the information they had at that point was because of Don. The detective said that all through their investigation, he had been calm and happy to answer their questions in depth, almost as if he was proud of what he had done. By the time the cop finished the story, I was almost catatonic. I couldn't believe what I was hearing, and at first, I thought this was all a dream. I pinched myself just to make sure. Even today, when I tell people who knew him what he did, they're shocked almost as much as I was. The detective spent the next hour asking me questions about Don and if I knew why he would do such a thing. There was very little I could give him. Don had always been sarcastic, but never violent in any way. I was out of it for most of the remainder of that day. I still didn't understand what had happened until I relayed the story to my wife and listened to the words as they came out of my mouth. This all happened in August of last year. As of the time I'm writing this, Don is scheduled to begin his trial the first week of April. The charges are one count of second-degree murder and one count of attempted murder. Despite being offered a more than fair plea deal, he's chosen to take it the whole way. Regardless of the result, he'll probably be spending the next 40-plus years in prison. This thought eats me up inside. Even if I couldn't stand the kid, it all just seems like such a terrible waste. Like any reasonable man, my dad took the medium's words with a very small pinch of salt. His girlfriend at the time had took him down to the palm reader's place to see his future. She claimed upon their meeting that he felt he had some type of danger going ahead. He didn't put much credit into this psychic mumbo-jumbo, but he loved the girl and was willing to do almost anything to make her happy. The old woman said he was in grave danger and should be very careful where he went. He laughed it off and paid her. Outside of the shop, the girlfriend whined at him for not taking it seriously. He stared into the beautiful blue eyes of the hippie girl and assured her he would watch out. Inside, however, he was laughing at the unfounded fear she was feeling and had no intent in changing the way he lived his life. This is how he said it all began. He and my mom had just started dating earlier that summer, and he was falling deeply in love with her by the day. Despite her new age,